In a previous video about the continuously variable transmission differential, I received a few questions. First of all, I'm not sure if it was really clear why this would be useful. So I'm going to link in the description to Engineering Explained, and he goes into very much detail about why this is a useful principle to use. So you can check that out. And now, in the comment section of my video, Luke asked a question, does this change the torque or just the velocity? And of course he's talking about the output shaft here. So I wanted to address that question. And also, Jessica responded to that and suggested that we put a worm gear on the variator side here to increase the torque of the variator. So I went ahead and rebuilt it with that worm gear, and then a lot more power on the drive motor side, so we've got a large difference in power on the two sides. Now, as far as Luke's question goes, can we change the torque coming out of the system? We can have the drive motor running full speed, and we can have the variator spin the output shaft backwards so that it doesn't move at all. So that wouldn't be any torque coming out of the system. And then also, if the drive motor is spinning one way and the variator is spinning the differential the opposite way, then we're going to be going in reverse here, and the amount of torque will be dependent on the speed of the variator motor. So if we turn the drive motor on and then we make this go in reverse here, it's not going to have very much push back against my finger here. So we have reduced the torque, but only in reverse. Now, as far as changing the torque in the forward direction, it acts a little bit weird. So first let's look at increasing the torque. Now, I'm going to turn on the drive motor turning clockwise here, and then I'm going to turn on the variator to increase the speed going clockwise. And what you'll see is that when the axle hits resistance, the variator side will stop, and we'll basically only be using the torque from the drive motors. So there's the drive motor spinning, and you can see it's got enough torque to open that spring up, and then turn on the variator side and the speed picks up, but not when it's under pressure because the variator is stopping under that resistance. Now, if I increase the power on the variator side, it'll be able to keep up with that resistance, and then it starts to put torque into the system on top of the drive motor. So we can't add torque to the system, but the variator has to be strong enough to do that. As a matter of fact, there's nothing about this that says that the variator needs to be on this side of the differential. You could swap places and it would do the same thing. Alright, now, as far as reducing the torque from the drive motors by reversing the spin direction with the variator, it's actually not going to work very well. We can slow down the output shaft unless there's a resistance to it, and then it's going to pick back up to the speed of the drive shaft. It's kind of weird. So I'll turn on that drive motor, and then I'll slow it down with the variator. And now that's moving pretty slow until I put resistance on it, and then it's going to start pushing back on me. You can see the variator stops moving under resistance. So that's a little bit about how the torque is moving in this thing. You know, one more thing I wanted to point out here, and I don't think Engineering Explained goes into it, but if you had a hybrid, you would have a gas motor and you would have an electric motor. And say you're sitting stopped at a stop sign or something, and you just lightly touch your gas, your throttle that is, your gas motor isn't going to turn on right away. Your electric motor will get you started moving. So that's, you know, like this motor here starting you up. And then you press the throttle some more and you need more power, so your gas motor is going to turn on and give you more torque. So now we've got both of those systems being able to, both of these energy sources are able to push on the same drive shafts separately. So now in a hybrid, and this was also pointed out by Jessica, who suggested the worm gear, But she pointed out that this is similar to the transmission in a hybrid. And now in a hybrid, you're going to be using planetary gears, not a differential. But it's a very similar sort of thing that's going on, where you're able to turn a shaft in the center, and you're also able to turn the housing that surrounds the gears that are connected to that shaft to increase that shaft speed that way also. So now one more thing I wanted to go over here real quick. This thing's got a really weird behavior. If the drive motor is spinning one way and the variator is spinning the shaft the other direction so that it's going in reverse, and then you push on the output shaft in the direction that it's trying to go, it will reverse its direction and push back on you. So there's the drive motor going forward, and now the variator is going to pick up, send that backwards a little bit. Now if I push, it's going to push back on me here. It's really weird. The harder I push, the more it pushes back. Okay, well, thanks for watching.